Hello there. Now I want you to look at this pen. Look carefully at this pen. Look at the top, look at the bottom. All right, so now do you think I can sell this exact pen to anyone I meet on the street? If yes, what are the exact four steps I'm going to follow to be able to achieve just that? How can I do this? And then the other question I have for you is, can I really sell anything to anyone? Can you sell anything to anyone? And can someone sell anything to anyone? If the answer is yes, exactly how do we do this? And if the answer is no, what are the limits? Because I believe, my friend, that if you know the exact limits, how you can sell anything to anyone or come as close as possible, this is the most important superpower you can have in the world. So let's cover all that. Alrighty, welcome friends. My name is Peter Antonov, the founder of Global Expert Space, and this is what we are going to cover in this video. If this is the first video you see from us, consider subscribing. We help you succeed in business, in life, and I believe that we have the most step-by-step specific videos on how to achieve just that. So like this video, let me know what you think in the comments, and consider subscribing. Now, here's the thing. If I come on this video and if I say, alrighty guys, so now in the comments, I want you to say who wants to come to Vegas, where our office is, and sell me this pen. And people would say, Peter, yes, I would come to Vegas, I can sell you this pen. So imagine I meet 10 people coming to our Las Vegas office, and all of them are trying to sell me this pen. Now, what most people are going to do is they're going to come to me and they're going to say, Peter, I want you to look at this pen. Look at how beautiful it is. Now, this is a black pen, so this is a universal color. It's great for your office. You can use for anything. Other people would say, Peter, you see this little thing at the top? Pay attention to this. Now, this thing you can actually use for your iPhone or Android phone, so you have to use your fingers. And people would keep telling me the features, right? What is good about the pen, and they would keep talking and talking and talking, and that's how most people are trying to sell. Now, the interesting thing though is that if you ask someone, for example, I have over 10 years of experience in sales, I've done some of the hardest jobs in selling you can imagine, even before starting building our online businesses, becoming number two affiliate out of 30,000 affiliates, building successful companies, I've sold on the streets of New York, which is really tough, going door to door. Now, if you ask some of the most experienced salespeople in the whole world, if this is the right approach, just start talking about why the pain is good, they're going to laugh in your face because they just know this is the worst strategy you can ever attempt to use, selling someone something. Now, what a professional would do instead, and you might want to write this down, is the first step, they'll try to qualify you. Alrighty, and first you want to qualify people when it comes to this specific pen to actually see their intent. Are they even looking for a pen at the moment? Are they even looking for a pen at the moment? Now, even if they're not, that's fine. You can still make the sale, thankfully, right? However, you want to know. For example, you would ask, how long have you been looking for a pen? You know, so if someone comes to me and I tell you, sell me this pen, if you ask me this question, well, Peter, how long have you been looking for a pen? I know I have a professional salesman in front of me. I know I have someone that has a lot of experience. And I'm very likely to be buying this pen in 5 minutes from now, right? So they will tell me, Peter, how long have you been looking for a pen? And I would say, well, actually, I've been looking for a very specific pen for 3 months, right? For 4 months. So I would say, you know what? I'm actually not looking for a pen, which is perfectly fine. This is the first thing you want to know. You want to see if people have the intent, if they're already looking for what you're having to offer. Now, the second thing you want to know is basically if they say, yes, I have been looking for a pen, you would say, well, why are you still looking for a pen? Why are you still looking for a pen? And now here's the magic. Why are you still looking for a pen? Because remember, they've been looking for a pen, but they haven't bought the pen yet. So how come you've been looking for a pen, Peter, for 3 or 6 months, but you haven't bought it yet? And then the other person starts speaking, and what you do is you just shut your mouth, all right? That is why we have 2 ears and 1 mouth, because we have to be listening. So the other person starts speaking, and they tell you all the secrets you need to know. Well, you know what? I've been looking for pens for 6 months, and I bought a bunch of pens from Target and Walmart. However, I just can't find the specific pen I'm looking for. I want a pen that not only looks beautiful, that is great. However, I want a pen that writes in a very specific way. I want the ink from the pen to be thick. I don't want it to be thin, but I don't want it to be very thick so that it goes all over the page. I'm just looking for something very specific. So when I write, I do these, gift cards, so I send gifts to my friend, and all I want when I write these gift cards, when people see my card, to be thinking, wow, that's a very professional ink. And I just couldn't be able to find this type of ink yet on a pen. And now you know, you have some really important information that you can use right back at the person to actually make the sale and close the deal if you speak to people personally. Better yet, if you sell online, you don't even have to speak to them, but put these words on a page, which is the best thing you can ever do. But now here's the thing. So if they tell you, yes, I've been looking for a pen, you ask them exactly why are they still looking for a pen, right? But then if they tell you, for example, no, actually I'm not looking for a pen, you ask them this second question instead, which is, well, how do you think the right pen can really help you? How do you think the right pen can really help you? And you ask this question, well, Peter, how do you think the right pen can really help you? And people start imagining in their head, how can the right pen can really help them? They're coming up with the solution themselves. So even, here's the magic, even if they haven't been looking for a pen before, and you just come up with the idea, when you say, well, how do you think the right pen can change your life, how can it help you, they start thinking, well, maybe the right pen would look really nice, it would match my clothes, or maybe it would do this, it would do that. And then you go to step number three, which is the key. Almost no one is doing it in sales, online, physically, and if you learn how to do this, you can sell almost anyone anything, which I'm going to speak in a second what the limits are. I'm not going to give you a really important document. Here's step number three, alrighty? What you do is acknowledge what they just told you and you share a story. Right? So for example, imagine I told the other person, well, you know, I'm looking for this exact pen with the specific ink so that it's thick, but it's not very thick so that it makes a mess on the actual page, but it's just enough, right? And what the other person should say, the good salesman would say, you know what, it's really interesting you mentioned that. Oh, that makes a lot of sense. Oh, that's really interesting what you said that. Yeah, you're saying that it has to be just the right ink because most pens have this other ink that is just not good enough. And it's really interesting that you say that. So you acknowledge what the other person said, you repeat the exact same thing, and then you share a story. And now here's the story that you share. What you say is basically you realizing the same thing that the person told you some time ago, or you share a story of how your customer found your product, your pen, or your solution, or someone else, and they thought, wow, this is the exact solution. For example, I might say, hey, that's really interesting that you mentioned this, that you look for this pen for this specific ink, because you know, some 6 months ago we had a customer come to our store and she was looking at the pens and she bought 100 pens at once. And I asked her, that's crazy, why do you spend so much money on these most expensive pens? For example, why did you buy them so fast? And she said, you know what, Peter, I was looking for pens like this for a year because all these other pens are having this other ink that is just not good enough, and I wanted to buy for people in my company because I have 100 people that are managers in my company, executives, and I want to buy them gifts. I want to buy all 100 of them, 100 pens, but I never found the right pen, and now I saw that you have the right pens in your store, and that's why I decided to buy 100. And you say to the other person, so I had this lady come to me and she decided to buy 100, and I asked her, well, why did you buy these 100 pens? And she told me, because of the ink. And now that you tell me that you're looking for a pen with this kind of ink, it makes a lot of sense, because just 6 months ago, I didn't know how important the ink is, but this customer bought it because she couldn't find it elsewhere. And that's why I realized that maybe our pens really do have this link. It's really interesting. So you see what I did there? So without convincing the person that this is the right pen for them, all right, without telling them, well, actually this pen has this exact ink, you can't say this in sales. You can't tell to people, well, this is the exact pen, you're looking for this ink, well, I have this ink. You can't say this, because that way the person feels like basically you're trying to convince them. No one wants to be convinced. People don't like to be sold. What do people like? People like to buy. People like to buy. But when you say, hey, you know, I had a customer, they told me this exact thing and this is what they mentioned, now you just share a story and your person is saying, oh my God, I'm in the exact same situation. Well, how about I also buy 100 pens? Isn't this crazy? That is how you sell. I see so many people struggling in business, and yet the most important thing is to come, which you have to pay attention to that. But then the way you close the deal, which is step number four, scarcity. All right, what you do is you give people a specific time to where they can buy this pen. All right, if you don't give scarcity, you can't make a sale. remember this, you can never ever make a sale. I mean, you can, but people are used to buying on scarcity. Now, what this means? What this means is, you know, unfortunately, we only have 5 pence left. And for example, someone is buying a pen every single day, or we have a promotion and this promotion is going to expire in 7 days. If you don't give people an incentive to act when? Now, all right? Or maybe tomorrow when the promotion expires, they're not going to buy. So anytime you want anyone to do anything, you need to have scarcity. You need to have a time limit. When is the offer expiring, right? And anything you do, you can do affiliate marketing, network marketing, physical based business, online business, store, you can always run promotions. You can tell people, listen, I'm looking for 5 more people to work with, or listen, I have only 5 of these. You can always give people time horizon on when they can take advantage of this. Alrighty, now the next real key you have to understand is right here. Now this is the real secret. So can you really sell anything to anyone? Can you really sell anything to anyone? As I gave you the example with the pen, all right, we first have to qualify people. We have to know if they're looking for it. If they're not looking for it, we have to make them come up with why they want it. And then we have to share a story of someone else deciding to buy. And then we have to give them scarcity. However, can you really make anyone buy anything? And here's the deal though. A lot of people would make you believe, yes, you can make anyone buy anything. However, the truth is that, you know, you can. So here's the thing, like, you can take anyone on the street, you can take any of your friends, any of the people you know, any of your customers, you can take anyone and you can sell them something different based on their needs, because everyone is looking for a different thing, everyone has different needs. So you can sell anyone something different based on their needs, or you can sell some people anything. So you can take anything and you can sell it to some people, or you can have anyone and you can sell all these people something different, but it's impossible to sell anyone anything. It's just impossible to sell anyone anything because people have different needs, and a lot of people would make you to believe on the internet, yes, you can sell anything to anyone, but it's just impossible. However, you can sell anything. You can sell this pen to some people, and you can sell anyone something different, but you can't sell anyone anything. Now, if you like this video, I have something amazing for you. We created a special document. It's a Word document that is basically helping people achieve their financial goals. And the way it's happening is from the book Thinking Grow Rich, and we improved it and we combined it. So you basically, it's a document that you print. And when you print it, you just fill. You fill your financial goal, then you say what you're going to give in return, because this is really how you make money, right? In sales, in anything. Like, you decide how much money you want, you decide the time frame that you want it in, and you decide what you're going to give in return for this money, and then you keep repeating certain statements that you're going to see on the actual document, and you make it happen. We've had tons of people that say this document has changed their life, so you have to check it out. Now, in the description below, you're going to find it, you're going to click. It's only going to ask you, I believe, the email where we have to send the document, and you're going to immediately receive this document in your mailbox. So start filling this document out today, start using it today, so you can start making the money that you want. As you can see, making money with sales is very easy. You know, you can decide to sell anything. If you don't have a product yet, that is perfectly fine. We cover a lot of this stuff in our videos, because remember, this channel is all about how to succeed in your business and life. So that's pretty much it from me. Like this video if you like this. Tell me in the comments, do you think that's true? Do you think you can really sell anything to anyone? Do you agree with me that it's impossible to say anything to anyone, right? But it is possible to qualify people, and you can sell anyone who is sellable. So what do you think about this? Like this video, let me know what you think in the comments. Subscribe to this channel. We're coming with better videos than this one all the time. And last but not least, click to download this document. It is possible. It's going to change your life. So thank you so much. See you. Peter Antonov, founder of Global Expert Space.